All right, everybody, welcome. Thanks so much for joining us for the last of the DABL 2021 session. Today, we'll be talking about what's next and kind of having a round table with some of our past presenters. This will be interactive a little bit later on. So if you want to chat with us, you're more than welcome to unmute or chat us in the chat box. So I think that we'll just do around the room. So hi, my name is Sarah Aqua. I work for Dainard's BioLocal as an event producer. So I produce this session and some of the art pop-ups that we have, you know, during normal times. I think I'm just gonna kind of call on some of the people to make it a little easier for us. So Olivia, why don't you go ahead and go next?
Yeah, thanks, Sarah. I'm Olivia Wisden. I am the CEO of Underbelly, a creative now based out of Milwaukee, but originally kind of based in the Madison area. And I've been working with the DABL team, kind of doing the social media promotions and kind of some of the graphics. So it's been a great few months.
Awesome. Adalia, if you want to go ahead and go next, give us some updates about your life as well.
Sure. Thanks, Sarah. Hi, everyone. My name is Adalia Hernandez-Aprico, and I worked with the Dainard's team or Dainard's staff for the past year and a half. And I just recently graduated with my master's degree at UW-Madison with the Bull Center for Arts Administration. It's great to be here and see everyone today.
Awesome. Thanks. And congratulations on graduating. Augusta, this is going to be a new face for most of you. So if you want to go ahead and unmute and introduce yourself.
Hello, I recognize a lot of you. My name is Augusta Barula, and I've just joined Dainard's as a cultural affairs specialist. My background is in mostly visual arts, both nonprofit and for-profit, and I've been dancing flamenco for over 16 years, so involved in performing arts as well. So I'm really excited to be on the team and to meet all of you.
Awesome, welcome. That's a cool fact I did not know about the flamenco dancing. Let's see here. I'm going to have Angela Johnson go next, if you wouldn't mind introducing yourself.
Sure. Thank you, Sarah. Good evening, everyone. My name is Angela Johnson. I'm a professional artist, small business owner, educator, and entrepreneur in Madison. And I've been teaching or working within the arts for over 20 years. So,
awesome. And
I'm from Madison. I've not always lived here, but I've been back.
That's great. Yeah, Madison sucks everybody back in. Okay, go ahead, Mark Weller.
Hey there, I had to unmute. I'm Mark Weller. I am an artist. I do time stacking photography. The synopsis of my career is I was a filmmaker for public television for 15 years, based here for the majority of that time, but up in Alaska for several years. And then I got out of art and got into business. And was the president and CEO of a telecom corporation for 27 years. I've retired from that, and I'm now doing photography full-time.
Awesome, thank you. Mark, if you wanna go ahead and introduce yourself, and if you wanna take over, you're more than welcome to, otherwise I can keep rolling.
I'm sorry, I've been on the road for 5 hours and just settled into a place on my way to somewhere else, so I apologize for being late and discombobulated. And trying to figure out the room I'm in and how to make this work. So I'm Mark, the director of Dainard's. Thank you all for joining us. It's been a crazy year for us all. And hopefully DABL's been some kind of a respite to discuss creative activities and opportunities for all of us. So thank you for being here. And I'm anxious to hear some of your opinions and thoughts about how DABL's gone for this year and whether you appreciated the presentations, what worked, what didn't work, what are your ideas? Should we continue with 22? And other ideas that you have about your own work as an artist in representing Dane County. And there's so many exciting things happening that this is a great opportunity just for this hour to discuss who, what, where, when, how, and why. Thank you.
Awesome, thanks, Mark. So just a little recap of what we're gonna be doing today, or an agenda of sorts. I just popped our first question in the chat. We're gonna go through our first question, then we're gonna have some spoken word poetry by Shaspray, and then we're gonna go through our second question and kind of just do a roundtable, pretty casual discussion. So the first question, if you're not looking at the chat, is we're gonna do a little bit of a review of 2021. So we wanna talk about the format, what you thought worked, what didn't work, go through 2022 suggestions, like how frequent we should have these workshops, ideas for guest hosts, presenters, the format, etc. So everyone is welcome to unmute if they want to go ahead and chat freely. Otherwise, you can also chat in the chat box. And I am really good at waiting in silence. I learned that from Angela Johnson. So I'm going to give a couple seconds here for anyone's thoughts.
Well, you don't need a couple seconds. I'll jump in. when I think back to, or that'd be March of 2020, or actually January of 2020, you know, as an artist, I was booked the entire year. I was thinking that this was going to be my breakthrough year. And come March, when the pandemic hit, every single show that I was booked in, every single deal that I had pending, canceled. And by the end of March, I had zero income and no prospects. And I thought, well, this is it. I'm going to go down. One of the things I thought DABL did was provided a forum to at least talk to other artists, get some ideas, see how they were dealing with a pandemic, which was great. As we all know, sometimes sitting in a studio by yourself day after day, and in my case, you know, I'm out on the countryside, but 99% of the time it's by myself, can be a very lonely experience. And the notion of at least on a monthly basis, talking to other folks, listening to other folks, some I didn't know, some had ideas that I hadn't thought of, was very beneficial. So I thought the way DABL pivoted in a mess that we were all mutually experiencing was well worthwhile.
Yeah, thanks so much, Mark. I mean, that's definitely, you know, like kind of the idea. I think that no one was really prepared for like the trauma of what was going to happen. And I think that a lot of us were, you know, hoping for the best and preparing for the worst. And I think that this definitely fit in nicely. So thanks for that.
Well, we were initially going to do this anyway, hold more classes and workshops, but at Promega in person. So this process of going online and through Zoom has been very helpful. And it's really been amazing to see the creative work coming out from a lot of artists. Who have now just pivoted to working through Zoom until we find a better mechanism to work safely in person. So thanks, Mark.
Yeah, definitely. And I think, you know, along with what you're saying, having us having planned to do more workshops in person before the pandemic even was like a thing, you know, more felt like a professional development, like how can we support artists? And I think that, you know, Mark Weller, you nailed it on the head of like, it ended up being that for sure, but also a lot of like community building for artists during difficult times. You know, like when I'm looking back at it, it definitely feels like well worth our time, you know.
One thing that I really appreciated is that they're being recorded and you can go back and look at the archive. So if I couldn't make it to Promega, if my schedule didn't permit, it was fantastic. I've viewed into a couple this spring, but I didn't realize there was the backlog from last year too. And so when I heard that in one of the recent sessions I listened to, I went back and I've watched three of them from 2020 and have kind of bookmarked to watch more. So I think it's a really great resource that you can go back to again and again.
Yeah, thank you. And just a reminder for everybody who is watching right now or will be watching in the future, we have, you know, like on YouTube or Facebook, we have all of our past recordings on our website. So that's dablmarket.com, dablmarket.com. And you just go ahead and click on the workshops tab on the top menu bar, and you can see all of our past workshops and recordings.
I really enjoy our panel discussions as like an attendee. I think it's really great. And I enjoy hearing from, but I think one of the things I would love to see move in the future was that the things that I take most like skill, like I guess hard skills, have definitely been kind of more of the one-on-one workshops. So like Angela Johnson, like yours, listening to, you know, learning about like copyright, like things I like I think about as a creativist, but like don't have the skill set for. And so I think having more of those workshops, especially since they do get saved that I'd be like, oh, I really, you know, having more of those kind of sprinkled in, I think would be something that I know we tried a little bit this year. Mm-hmm. It ended up being more kind of panel-y, but I think those workshops are super helpful as like to like build skills based.
Well, yeah, help us think what kind of workshops that would mean. I mean, TL Luke had indicated she would have liked to have seen more about the workshop she was a part of, being more specific to direct sales, you know, mail follow-up calls and that, cold calling, which it could have been, but we did focus quite a bit on the pandemic. So I'd welcome to hear what kind of workshops, and I'm not talking just visual artists, we're talking what is available to artists across disciplines. Mm-hmm. You know, we're doing a lot of work, but it seems we're all, a lot of us are in our silos with the work we do. So how can we build this and eventually get back person to person? And what kind of workshops would that mean, or panels that you'd like to hear or see or be a part of?
I'm not sure if logistically this would be a crazy idea, but what if it were a day long summit or at ProMega, where on the hour there's something happening each hour through a day, interspersed with disciplines, and maybe every other hour it's, you know, a lecture versus a workshop, and maybe the morning is more, you know, kind of admin business related, maybe it's more hands-on later. I don't know, that, you know, would be a lot to plan, obviously, but just thinking pie in the sky, perhaps.
But we actually, Angela, were thinking that for 2020, a summit of some kind, a week long, to take DABL to a week long with ProMega of workshops and activities. So that's spot on. We were actually hoping to do that. So if we do get back to in person, that's certainly one of the goals. In fact, ProMega and Daniel Sawadner has been in contact with DABL and Dane Arts about when we do come back together in the fall, can there be an exhibition? Can there be workshops? You know, what can happen? Because I know they're planning right now a summer exhibition, but they're not quite sure what. And I suggested outdoor activities, and everybody gets access to a golf cart. And ProMega is so huge, you can golf cart from one outdoor activity to the next, you know. And some of us can walk, and it's a biking city. Some of us can bike, you know. So we do hope to have that kind of summit. So thanks.
Yeah, and if I recall, I think maybe you mentioned this, but I think our original idea was, yeah, like the summit was going to be over several days, including an art market and art pop-up and a gallery. So we agree with the pie in the sky ideas. Thank you for that. Jericho, you are muted if you want to speak.
I wanted to ask, this summer still everything will be kind of more outdoorish and still keeping things virtual. And I was wondering if you are planning to do, because I was thinking I would like to do maybe like installation, like do something for people that they can, you know, since they cannot go to galleries and go to museums as much as they could before, and they are feeling safer outdoor, if there is a way how to apply for something like that, that you could get location and you could make offer like what is your idea, and if somebody would be interested to show it in a lot or something like that. This is my question.
Well, the new indoors is the outdoors. That's what we're learning. Mm-hmm. Well, one idea is working more closely with Bree Stevens and Big Top, because they're starting to do more outdoor markets and concerts. Certainly all their concerts are being sold out. So they just joined a project that we're working on called the Greater Madison Music City Project, and bringing equity and fairness to the music venues and many of the artists, particularly the hip hop artists and artists of color in the Madison area. So we're trying to work more closely with them. But I know they do a bodega, which is mostly crafts, but That's certainly an idea. And that's one I've been mulling with and working with Bree Stevens, Matt Big Top about an outdoor market there.
Well, I am looking not like market. I am looking more for location where there could be, like, you know, when they...
Press that space bar again.
Yeah, it says that you are muted. Now it says you're muted, so go ahead. Maybe if you leave the meeting and rejoin, sometimes that fixes the problem.
Oh, I wanted to hear it. Yark.
Me too.
But I think some kind of exhibition outdoors, a location outdoor exhibition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it sounded like she was getting something really interesting. Well, hopefully she gets back into the waiting room really, really quickly here.
Have you introduced Shashpare by chance? I see her name on
there. She's here, yep. We were gonna begin her spoken word performance in probably about 8 minutes here. Thank you. But if we could always do it earlier, if you feel that way.
No. No, if she was introduced, I got on a little bit late, so thank you.
Yeah.
There she is, all right. Are you eight? Shashpare, are you back in, you're not back in Mass, you're still in Austin, right?
Yes, I am still in good old Texas.
Hopefully it wasn't too bad recently with that storm for you.
It was awful, but it's all good now. It's all good now. I didn't get hit with all of the things that everyone did. I had electricity. I lost water for a day.
Yeah.
Some people are still without power,
really?
Which is really awful. Yeah.
That's terrible. So we have Yarka back. Yarka, if you want to go ahead and unmute, you can finish your thought.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
We can hear you.
I try to be off with the video. My computer is like ancient, this one. I have next to it new ones, but I didn't put this.
We lost her again. That's unfortunate.
It better wake those squirrels up. We all had those old computers. Oh my gosh. I still have two or three in my basement. Kind of afraid to give them up because you don't know about the hard drive and you destroy it and then put the toxins into the air. And when you give it, donate it, they don't take screens, but they take the laptop and you don't know what they're going to do with it. And then you find your name on some dark website in the middle of nowhere.
To be fair, your name's probably already on a dark website, but if you're going to keep your computer around, you want to make sure that the battery is not exploding, just FYI. It's what a lot of people end up doing, they're in their basement and they don't realize that the battery has exploded along all of their stuff. So keep that in mind. Or take the battery out.
I have a cell phone museum at my place. Literally, like every cell phone. 10 years.
Yeah, for sure. Let's see here. I think we kind of covered everything from question one. We talked a little bit about format, what worked. Also, if you have any like criticisms, don't be shy. We'd love to hear them. The criticism is just as helpful as any of your praises. So if there's anything you want to say, we take that just fine. We take your feedback and we incorporate it into the next year. So if you don't tell us, we can't fix it. So
I have one more thought. It's not a criticism, but just one thing that I really enjoyed was seeing these panel discussions. Again, I think as Mark was kind of bringing up how that sense of community and kind of showing that we're all in the same situation, and also hearing our differences in the panel that I participated in, where it was all like students, and how we're just kind of entering into the sector and kind of hearing each other's different backgrounds and, you know, various arts disciplines or just outside of the arts, and how, you know, all those different pathways still lead more or less to the same place. And again, kind of just having that opportunity to meet each other and kind of establish those connections, or you see familiar faces from some of these workshops. I think that definitely moves us in the right direction of collaborations and partnerships.
Yeah, that's such a good point.
Well, now that you bring that up, Adalia, we should have had you all on at the end as well to see that year of growth that you all experienced. And you may have matured by Zooming 8,000 times.
Yeah, I mean, I think that you're definitely, you know, in a unique position because you ended up doing your entire degree online. Is that right?
That's true. Yeah.
Which was definitely not the intention originally.
No. So even with Zoom, I feel like it was helpful just to see some faces and that whole storytelling piece.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I tell you, if you need motivation, I've got another computer up, and right now live Sotheby's is having one of their auctions. They've connected Hong Kong, New York, and was it London, I think? Anyway, Bansky's got a piece up, Love is in the Air. It was estimated to go for $3 million. Right now the bidding is at $9.1 million. So I watch this stuff and dream. I mean, it's just, it's eye candy. It's eye popping numbers where, you know, if you sit here for an hour or so, I don't know, 20, 30, 50, $70 million exchanges hands, all on art. And, you know, who amongst us doesn't dream that one day their piece is going to be at Sotheby's and it's going to be estimated at $3 million and it'll go for three times that. So, yep, we're in a good spot. Okay, I'll dream. I'll keep dreaming.
Dream big. All right. Yarka, if you want one last shot at finishing your thought, go for it.
I'm at work. Somebody's, I'm working too. So you got me, I got a microphone. So hopefully that will work. So my question was, if we would do something like outdoor, like more installation, more sculptural pieces, which could be in a, which could be outside through like through summer or part of the summer, that people can go visit and interact with them, take pictures with them, and you know, see work of the artists, of local artists, and still, you know, being like seeing the artist community. I love like what is happening downtown with all the graffitis and with all the you know, mural paintings on boards, and you know, just it's like this time it was hard, but as well it brought a new things, new idea, which are excellent. And I think for artists it is like these new opportunities, viewing things completely differently and embrace it. And I think that it would be fun to do something, you know, something like that.
Well, Yarka, one of the problems with that idea is we're going to ask you to help us.
I would love that. I would love that. I will be, you know, I'm part of the summer. I'm going to be gone. I'm going to Europe for a little bit, but I would love, you know, I already have idea in mind of what I would do. So I want to utilize all these found objects I have and do like from recycled materials to some installation artwork, sculptural artwork. So yeah, that's my plan. If I won't do it this summer, I'll have to do it next summer.
Yeah, that's a great idea. You can always put that in your back pocket for the next pandemic.
I hope not.
I know, sorry, I feel like curse everyone when I say that. All right, we're right about the halfway mark. So I'm thinking that it would be a great time for Shasbury to perform. So if you're ready, if you want to go ahead, that'd be great.
Sure, I can definitely do that. Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for having me. My name is Shasbury. My pronouns are she, her, hers. I am very excited to be here. It sounds like y'all having some great ideas and great conversations. I am no longer in the Madison area, but I've been doing a lot of things in Madison virtually, randomly. I went to school at UW, and it sounds like someone graduated from the program. I forget who it was.
Yeah, I graduated just recently.
How do you say your name?
My name is Adalia.
Adalia, yeah. The one that Sarah Marty is?
Yeah, I was in the Bull Center cohort.
Yeah, yeah. Sarah Marty is my mentor, so it's just like awesome. I know Deja, but nice to meet you. And I was supposed to be in that program, but the pandemic completely threw everything off and I ended up in Texas. So yeah, I am going to do a poem for you all, if that is all right. My focus is in primary performance poetry and spoken word poetry. Let me tell you about the best photos I have ever taken. I got hired to model for one of Walmart's plus size lines. Hair was done, face done, everything done. I pose and my melanin popped the camera lens off. I feel my ancestors push my shoulders back. I fix my face like no one has called me ugly and meant it a synonym for fat. I hold my hands like I just got through casting a spell. I smile and suddenly the light pours in. I dared anyone to twist their lips and say I wasn't beautiful, because for one of the first times in my life, I acknowledged I was and I saw myself. Months later, Walmart employees follow me through the store. I thought maybe they recognized me, but this wasn't runway. I was just running errands. The true offense was shopping while Black. I smiled, I did, but it did not change their depth of field. I'm under the impression that my melanin got them wanting to pop off, so I leave. Wasn't gonna let white gaze dim my brightness, but they followed me. Couldn't even leave the parking lot before red, white, and blue pulls me over. I don't want to be America's next top martyr. So I pose, make myself into a model minority. When the cops pull up, I push my shoulders back and fix my face. My ancestors force my hands to the wheel. I open my mouth to speak, but hear Sandra and Philando say, "Is there a problem, officer?" The store called. They twisted their lips and said I stole something. Maybe if I had been as still or as white as their mannequins, they would have left me alone. How ironic that the same corporation that captures me tries to capture me, this time in a different light. I want to show them my headshots to clear up the confusion, but I don't want to get a headshot. Why can't I prove that Black bodies aren't just made for mugshots? Let me tell you about the worst photo I've ever taken. It's one they said they needed to put me on file for criminal trespassing, even though I went through the checkout line, even though I had a receipt. Tears are streaming down my face. And the cop told me to smile. He said to smile, as if I should be grateful that the click was followed with a flash and not a bang. Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Yeah, thanks so much.
That was beautiful, baby. That was beautiful. It was really, really straight up. Thank you. Do you have another one for us? Come on now.
I definitely could do another if y'all are, I don't want to take up too much space. I mean, y'all are.
I think another one would be great. I think we definitely have time.
Okay, cool.
We're going now. Let's go.
Okay, awesome. Okay, let me see. Okay, so yeah. All of my poems are, you know, based on like true stories and experiences. I definitely think you should write your life and tell your story. So that has been my experience and what I've tried to do. And so this next poem is about my experience in conversation with some fat phobia and bullying that I've seen and experienced on Facebook and online and stuff. Quantasia Sharpton filed a lawsuit against Usher Raymond with two other accusers. Usher allegedly exposed them to genital herpes, and yet the focal point became Quantasia's size, because not many have enough willing suspension of disbelief to believe that a star would want to sleep with a fat chick confession. I've memorized every Facebook comment. Behind every fat girl is a beautiful woman. Get out the way, comment. Fat girls are like scooters. They are fun to ride until somebody sees you. I used to call this weight loss motivation. I ready myself for the roast. They torch big bodies like this to shame. Usher comments, "She ain't my type." He points back to all the supermodels of his past.
Like, I haven't heard that before. Like, I don't date big girls has ever kept a man for wanting to take a bite of me. So many are ashamed that they pig out at the big girl buffet. Usher denies sleeping with that before he denies being infected with that comment, that hole, that big bone, that off switch, that hide me in your sheets because I won't fit in your closet, that won't speak to me on the street but wants me to be a freak in his bed. They called her ugly. But I know I'm pretty enough to plow. Cause you got that precious fetish, and I'm conditioned to be grateful to anyone who wants to feast on this fat fesh confession. I got more likes on Facebook for losing 20 pounds than I got for getting a full ride scholarship. I live in a world where being obese might be worse than spreading a disease willingly, Usher. Do you remember? Kanye's mother passed because of weight loss surgery confession. Some of us are dying to fit in. I know the risk, but still dream of getting these flaws fixed. Confession, I love taking selfies because you don't get to see the rest of me. My ex-boo leans in, says, wow, I can't believe Usher would go for someone like that. Confession, he is half my size. Confession, I take up way too much space in our bed. Confession, I do not want to be loved in spite of my weight. Usher, I hope you hear this and share with your fans so they see I'm human too. Do you care to comment? Your mother is a big woman. Have you nothing to say? I wonder, when she held you in her plush arms, did she think you would grow up to look down on her? I wonder if she wonders if anyone will ever love her for all of her Quantasia. Us big girls have to learn to be comfortable with the space we take up. We shine, despite what they say. Who are we kidding? Everyone is just trying to love themselves and be loved. I smile because they are uncomfortable with how unapologetic we are. We are not the joke. We are not the joke. This body is not your punchline. Listen, I'm still laughing because I can skip leg day and still run this world. Thank you. Awkward.
It's
like there's no
doing
anymore.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Very wow, powerful.
Thank you for having me so much.
Wow, that was really, really amazing. Thank you so much. I really love the moments between when you start and that moment to getting to that place to start. That's as fascinating as your work. And your work is very strong. I mean, it's almost like that silent moment when that actor has the grip of the audience in his lap and he just milks that silent moment. I mean, you could milk it a little bit longer. That was beautiful. That was powerful. And as a big boy, I know what you're talking about.
Jasper, follow you? Where can we see more of your work? Do you have a website or anything?
Yeah, sure. I do have a website. I'm actually in the process of like rebooting it, but I can send you my social media, and if anyone like wants to bless me, I have like a Patreon and just different ways you can follow me. I'll link that as well as my website in the chat.
Yeah, thanks. We'd love to put it on our site too, so people can find you later. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you all.
It's like hard to move back into like our questions after like that, you know, but thank you. It was really wonderful.
Well, it gives food for thought about our work and moving back into it, because as one of our sessions we had, you know, the elephant in the room is the idea about race and issues and culture and differences and similarities and access, which is very big in the arts community right now, because we're all struggling with how do we create a Dane County that is accessible to everybody and inclusive of the work, you know. Mark, I don't know, Mark, we found Mark Weller by happenstance at a bar when I walked by you. That's how we met and grew this incredible relationship. You know, so all of you have this incredible power, but we're not connecting everybody enough. And then maybe that's part of what DABL could be, if all of you want to help us think through how best to make this even stronger with all your input. But man, sorry, I'm going off on a tangent.
No, I mean, I think that goes nicely with our second question, is basically like, what's next? Not that how are you feeling about summer, but like, what's next? What do we want to create? What do we want to be doing? What do we think's happening?
As I say at the end of every year, okay, we're done with DABL. It's done. No more. Should we do a 2022? And what are your ideas? And help me manage, make this happen. Let's make it bigger and better.
Yes, you do tell us that every year, and then every year I convince you that it's a wonderful thing with all of our artists here.
I would, if that's the question on the table, then let me give you my two ideas. One is the recognition that artists are still in the middle of a pandemic like the rest of society. I know things are beginning to perk up a little bit, but it's not the good old days. And I'm not sure the good old days are going to return. But the fact that, you know, Mark, you've been working with the county executive there's $1 million grant that's in the works. You know, those things don't just fall from the sky. So Mark, I appreciate your efforts. I'm sure you whispered in a loud tone to the county executive that if money becomes available, creatives need to participate in that. By luck today, I spent some time with the county executive, and that's what I talked to him about. And mentioned your name, said how critical this is, thanked him, said, I know this is coming up in front of the county board. You know, what advice you have to get that through? First of all, he thought that this was not controversial. He thought that the board would probably okay it. The money's there. So he was not particularly worried, but he said artists should contact their county board supervisors and reach out to them to say, this is coming up. This is important to me as an artist, and this is why. And if it's just crickets, if it's just silence, you know, we may not get everything we need. So that's number one, this recognition that we're hurting and we need money. We're all running businesses. Businesses run on revenue. And I don't know about you guys, but I am significantly down. I've got a few prospects coming up. You know, we may end the year strong, but here we are sitting not even halfway through, and it's looking as bad now as it did a year ago. So, you know, we're just scraping by. So that's number one. Number two, what I thought was very helpful in the past, and which I made sales just about every time, not necessarily the night of, but I met people, kept in contact, followed up, and got some sales. And that is, you know, we had it at the distillery the last, 2 years or so. And I know there's talk that maybe in October we'll do something at Garver, but I would really encourage you to do that. There is something about seeing a piece of art, talking to the artist, you know, being in a festive location with lots of other people, lots of other artists, that helps and works on a number of levels. And I would encourage you to give that some very careful thought. If given the opportunity, I will, I'll throw my hat in the ring to say, pick me. I will be there. I'll bring my best stuff. I'll be ready to conduct business.
Thanks, Mark. We love the enthusiasm. You've definitely been one of our top guys. You know, we have you every year. Your art's fantastic and people like it. They buy it, you follow up, you're very professional. You know, and we appreciate that. Like when we put on these, you know, larger events, there's something very special about seeing artists like show up to their maximum, you know, and I would say that all of our DABL artists do that. So thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. You know why I do that? Because the first year I didn't make the cut. And oh, really? I felt like the gauntlet had been placed, and I was not ever going to let that happen again.
Well, I was not around that first year, so it's not my fault.
It's because you weren't around that first year, so yes, it is your fault. Mark, what was the context of your conversation with Joe? Was it at some kind of ceremony, a dedication, or
no? I belong to the Wanakee Chamber of Commerce, and they. Once a year, invite him in, and on Zoom, it's a pretty intimate thing. I think there's maybe Joe and 10, 12 other people on Zoom. So we all had time to chat a little bit. And he remembered, he knew exactly what I was talking about. So it's on his radar.
Awesome.
Great. Well, I appreciate that very much. You're absolutely right. We need to reach out to every supervisor. I think this is, it's still going to be a go whether we reach out to every supervisor. We should do that on a regular basis because there's so much on their plate. And it's right about the time now, May, June, July, that they decide the budget for 2022. But you're absolutely right. If no one's saying anything and it's just either Karen Wolf at the Mass and Arts Commission or me at Dane Arts, you know, saying, come on. It's like, okay, why?
You're absolutely right. When I was running a corporation, I spent all kinds of time up at the Capitol and I had two additional lobbyists that I paid for. And it wasn't that we were pushing what we wanted. It was just to make sure we didn't get forgotten. And that's probably half the battle is all of these elected officials are, people are at their sleeves pulling them in different directions. And, you know, the reality is the people who get to them last before they make a vote is the people who they remember. And so you can't put yourself in that spot. You've got to keep your issue in front of folks. And so we need to keep the issue of arts funding in front of the city council, county board rather, not being a pest of ourselves, not threatening, not, you know, making this controversial or anything like that, but just to keep our place in line.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Thank you so much for saying that. Yes.
I'm going to jump in and introduce myself. I'm Christina Brungard. I don't think I've met everyone here. I'm with MMOCA. I'm the, I can't say new director anymore. I've been here for 9 months, shockingly. No,
you are the new kid on the block.
I'm new. But your question, what you're talking about actually raises a question for me. Is there a group that lobbies for the arts in the city that everyone is members of specifically? I'm trying to... No, I'm seeing Mark shake his head no, but I'm thinking that is a really important step we might look at.
Madison has tried to create a Madison Arts Commission or a Madison Cultural Arts Office, but that's never gone anywhere. It's been killed by higher ups.
Oh.
There hasn't been a case made strong enough, supposedly, to have an office for cultural arts for the city. And Dane County, Dane Arts and Dane County Cultural Affairs, as you probably know, is one of the few in the state, I mean, in the country, that's actually dedicated to arts and culture. Usually it's parks and recreation, arts and culture, overseen by a manager that may know nothing about any of those.
Mm-hmm.
But no dedicated office in the city of Madison.
Okay.
And you're absolutely right. No, there's no arts council.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yes.
I'm used to belonging to a museum group that group lobbies together for our state funding, which helps because
yeah.
Somebody else is that bug in the air and a professional bug in the air, which I am not good at.
Yes.
I can be, but.
Yeah, related to like collaboration, I was wondering if any visual artists are interested in or have ever tried being in a collective in order to work with vendors, thinking about framing, thinking about supplies. Is that something that anyone's ever tried? Like, how can individual artists band together to get like wholesale discounts working with vendors to make their practice more affordable?
Not about necessarily like supplies, but I've been a part of a couple different things over the past like 7 years. One early on was a queer DJ collective. So it wasn't super organized like officially, but it was essentially like working together to make sure that we're paid fairly like in relation to non-queer artists. And it definitely skewed heavier on artists of color as well. Specifically, this is only DJs. So a lot of it was just like general like support, you know, like a lot of us were women or non-binary, all of us were queer, a lot of us were color, like all of those things are kind of like, you know, face some other challenges in the DJ and nightlife world. So we did some collaboration, just collective work with that, but never anything about like supplies or discounts or anything like that, or like lobbying or that sort of thing.
Interesting. Yeah, I'm also like really, along with the Equity for Artists movement, interested to learn more about market value in Wisconsin. Like for visual artists, I don't know if there's a lot of information on what is the market rate in Wisconsin. I think that could be applied to performing arts as well. If there was a database where artists put what they charge for services or products, we would know more what things are going for and, you know, what people could charge so they're not underselling themselves.
Sounds like a great workshop.
Are there any museums that are wage qualified, certified in Wisconsin?
Explain that. I'm not quite sure what you mean.
Oh, wage is an artist collective kind of group out of New York that came together, and now it's across the country, where they set what wage rates are for arts institutions, for speaker fees, artist fees, that sort of thing. And so it's a little uneven because the way it's set, it's not quite looking at real budget line necessarily. It looks at like a 990 sometimes and not necessarily hitting the real line, but it is kind of a good marker of how it's being paid. I believe so.
Yeah, I dropped a link in the chat. I think this is from what I was talking about.
That's it.
Cool.
Before I forget, Christina, have you been involved with Curators Conversations, David Wells?
No, I have not.
Should totally get connected with Curators Conversations. Yeah, David Wells at Edgewood. I think he was one of the leaders, but they would get together twice a year before the pandemic. It was a really great way for curators to share what they were doing, share resources.
And he's a monster in the community. So he's been well known for his work for many, many years. He's been at Edgewood Gallery, which is the Diane Baldwin Gallery, I believe, for the past several years, if you haven't met him yet. Karin Wolf and him work together quite a bit, and they do a lot of amazing work. So we should make that connection happen for you. David Wells, yes. Great idea.
And the curators conversation note too, historically the twice a year would go to different museums, from the Chazen to Museum of Wisconsin Art. So it's a great way to get connected and kind of current topics that, you know, a lot of galleries and museums experience. So I'm just echoing what Mark and Augusta said. It's like a phenomenal group. There's also a Facebook group as well.
Is it statewide or is it just Dane County or is it Madison? Statewide.
It's statewide.
It's called Curators Conversation.
Great. Yes, it is. Yeah, the Facebook group, as you know, Angela, it's been a little active during the pandemic, where people will a little bit. It's been pretty quiet.
Here and there.
Yeah, they discuss a lot of important issues, you know, that come up with museums and galleries.
Well, as we know, it always takes somebody crazy to convene this group of folks to make that happen. That's always the issue, and that's been my concern with individual artists is that it's difficult to get them to come together unless you have something exciting that's ongoing and solid and engaging. Because everybody is so busy, and so many artists, in particular visual and literary artists, are pretty much locked in their own space with themselves. As Mark Weller was saying, you're on your own as opposed to theater or dance. Those are great ideas. Dane Arts would be willing to put money forward towards somebody helping to organize something like that locally in Dane County, you know.
That's good to know. I know it's hard to get someone to do the administrative work and figure out how to actually make it happen.
Go to a meeting? No way. Yeah. And I'm willing to try and help raise money for that kind of activity. It's just that, you know, as you all know, we're a one-person office, 1.5-person office with Augusta, you know, so it's hard to get that all going. But I don't mind knocking on doors and asking people for money to support projects that are worthwhile. Because I think what we've learned, at least at Dane Art, since I've been there for 8 years, is that not a whole lot of people are as familiar with the work that we all do, whether it's Momoka or Dane Arts or Mark, your work, or anybody else, Sasperay and your literary work. It's having that ability to promote yourself regularly and keep people at the forefront of what you do. Well, Christina, let us know.
On me.
Yesterday, I was having a meeting with a group of folks, and we were trying to figure out who could be the chair. Of course, nobody is stepping forward to be the chair. And I suggested the last person to turn off their video is the chair.
That's a fair way to do that, Mark.
My video was already off, so it didn't matter.
It's like the last sharing that.
It's like the person that doesn't show up for that meeting becomes the chair.
I feel like that's a dangerous game. What if they never show up?
Well, that happens too.
Yeah. Steve, thank you so much for sharing that in the chat. Steve shared where to begin contacting your county supervisor to ask for arts funding and shared a link to board.countyofdane.com/supervisors.
You can send one, you can email to all of them at one time, or you can find your supervisor and send an email. And I really encourage that. That's a great idea.
Thanks. Awesome. We're getting a little close to the end. So I'm going to offer up a couple, if anybody has a couple last comments, and then we're going to wrap up with Mark telling us about some grant opportunities and talking about the upcoming DABL pop-up. And then we'll sign off. So maybe like one or two more comments or thoughts about what's next from anyone at all.
So can you just give it a reaction in the reaction? Ali, we have the button for the reaction. Should we do a DABL 2022 presentations and workshops?
Sure, yeah. So if you're unfamiliar with how to use reactions, if you hover your cursor down at the bottom of the screen, or yeah, you can just do it in your camera, but you can choose a thumbs up.
Can you provide us with some more suggestions and whether it should be once a month, twice a month, you know, and to contact us at Dane Arts, either my email, my last name at countyofdane.com, or I check the Dane Arts email regularly, danearts.com. Dane Arts? I don't know what Dane, what is it? Dane County? I don't know the Dane Arts email. Contact me.
I do. Let me find it. If you have anything specific about DABL, you can email us at dablemarket@gmail.com. That's dablmarket@gmail.com. You can also visit our website, dablemarket.com. That's also where you can find requests for a consultation. So if you're an artist or just feeling a little stuck or you just want to talk about some stuff with us, you can book like a short 30-minute consultation with us. This is also where you can see any of the past workshop recordings. And this is also where you can see any information upcoming about our pop-ups.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you for all the work you've done for this part of the DABL 2021. And we will be having a DABL market. That's our goal, November 6th, Saturday at Garver Feed Mill. And we're hoping we have hopefully at least 19 artists confirmed, depending on the size that we can keep. You know, maybe more than 19 artists safely spaced at Garver Feed Mill. But we are inviting artists this year in particular, because it's the first time that we're not doing a call for artists. We're actually going back through past DABL artists who've done a great deal of sales, who've been very successful in the work, and asking them to participate in this year's DABL. So it will be Saturday, November 6th from 11 to 4, I believe. And Sarah will be organizing that with Olivia and Augusta. So make sure you get that on your calendar. And make sure that you contact us for anything that you need through Dane Arts. We are all we're registering you all, if you haven't been yet, for our newsletter. And you can always unsubscribe if you'd like, but we want to keep you informed on a monthly basis about the things that are happening at Dane Arts. And the COVID relief funds that are supposed to be coming through, but we decided by the County Board of Supervisors on Thursday, May 20th, is what I was told. And so on Friday, May 21st, I'll check the Dane Arts website homepage for an update. Right now I have just a little blurb on 2021 and that DABL fund for, the Dang fund for individual independent working artists. Really simple application. It'll take you 4 to 5 minutes to fill out. Really have to show a history of your work. And it's really about providing you with just COVID relief funds. I've talked to a number of artists across discipline. This is not just visual artists, all artists across discipline who can prove that they've lost income related to the work they do as artists. But a lot of them are talking about putting this money towards a project for next year or in 2 months, which is great. It's your choice on how you want to use these dollars. But these are really about using these dollars to pay a bill, to pay your electricity, update your insurance, maybe your rent, maybe something special for you. And you certainly can use it towards a project. But in my negotiations with the county, it was more about these artists have been really hit hard through the pandemic. First of all, with the sales of art. Secondly, many of them have second and third jobs, and they're usually in the service industry, which has been decimated as well. We need to provide them with funds. The county initially said $2,000, and I said $2,000 with taxes would take down to $1,500. If it's $2,500, then $2,000 is something greater to work with. So we decided 400 artists, $2,500 each. There's no negotiation between $1,000 here, $1,500. It's $2,500 to all artists who qualify, and you won't be able to qualify if you don't apply. Now we're trying our best to really prepare for the onslaught on that May 21st, and we'll process them as quickly as possible. But I want you all to remember that this is the county and there are a lot of steps to go through to process a check. And usually one of the reasons for a delay in a check is because we didn't get the proper information from you. And we're pretty secure on our networks in terms of providing us with a W-9. You don't have to worry about it being hacked or hijacked, so we need a W-9 is all we need in the application. And the sooner that you can get that into us once this takes place, then the sooner that 2-week process of getting you a check will happen. So hopefully by the middle of June, those of you apply on May 21st and are accepted and awarded will get a check mid-June. And again, this is going to be juried. So there are going to be 5 jurors who across disciplines who are going to review the work on that one page to get a sense of whether or not you really should be awarded. And it's just an A&A process. And we'll get that going as quickly as possible. So that's May 21st. Go to the website at danearts.com for an update. And again, we are always available 24/7 to answer any questions you have related to Dane Arts. So thank you for your help this year and this season. Look forward to seeing you in November. And stay in touch because we have a lot going on. And I don't know if you wanted to add anything, Sarah or Olivia or Dahlia or Augusta.
He mostly covered it. I went ahead and just pasted some stuff in the chat or rather check out our website to keep up to date with the upcoming market and your website for Dang Grant stuff and Shasper's information. So everyone, thank you so much for joining us and helping us wrap up a very interesting year.
Shasper, you're hot and we get more work for you. All right, let us know if you ever come back to Madison.
But yeah, definitely.
Thank you.
I'll be back soon. I'll
let you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, everyone. Have a good night.
Hopefully to see you soon, guys.
I know you in November.
Yeah. Now we're going to talk to her in a couple of weeks about that summer exhibition.
Yeah, I will get in touch with you to talk. I'm going to be gone through June, most of June, but I was thinking something for August and, so I will get in touch with you and maybe, who knows, it'll be fun. Have fun.
Awesome.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to hang up now. Okay. So we'll talk to everybody later.
This is a Wisconsin goodbye if there ever was one.
Yeah. Okay. Bye,
it's so hard to say goodbye.
Let me walk everybody. Let me walk you to the curb. Would you like some rhubarb? I've got some squash.
Yeah. Right,
see you later.
See ya.
Thank you.
All right. Bye. Okay, cool. Let me stop.